Oh mate, yeah, it's me. I'm at the yard. You got any bricks left? I've got that one brick. That's all I've got left. I need some proper builder's bricks.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. This is the CAT S62 Pro review.
Okay, so if you want to see the damage from that fall, it was around waist height. You can see there's a couple of little knocks in there. You can see just on the frame, obviously the screen's intact and everything else. That's the only bit of damage.
Now, you just saw the S62 Pro dropped there. That was from around waist height. Tests have been done from head height, so maybe 1.8 meters high, from the actual company themselves and some other YouTubers as well. I have to send this phone back, so I didn't want to drop it from head height. If I didn't have to send it back, then I probably would have done this. So I decided to drop waist height purely because I think that's probably the most common sort of distance when you're trying to get it out of your pocket or put it back in, where I think you're most likely going to drop your phone. Now, this isn't just shockproof or drop proof, it's also waterproof, dustproof, pressure proof. And I accidentally on purpose put it in my washing machine at 40 degrees for 55 minutes. Have a look. Load's finished. It was set on a quick wash, 40 degrees. It took around about 55 minutes. So we'll look. I can feel something. Fell out the pocket. And here it is. So the back looks fine. The front looks fine, a bit smeary. Does it turn on? Oh, it accepted my fingerprint. Let's try again. Yeah, let's turn that down a little bit. So I just want to test the speaker, because in a lot of smartphones that are waterproof or, you know, rugged, the speakers or loudspeakers fill up with water and this is absolutely fine. Great stuff. So that was another test where in the real world, some people might accidentally put their phone in the wash. So I decided to do that 40 degrees, 55 minutes. And like you could see, it was absolutely fine. And I was quite surprised the loudspeaker worked straight away as well. Sometimes if rugged phones that I've used in the past have been submerged in water, then the loudspeaker takes a little bit of time to clear out, but this was absolutely fine. So what makes the CAT S62 Pro rugged?
It's an LCD display at 1080p, 5.7 inches, and protected with the highly scratch-resistant Corning Gorilla Glass 6. So the phone is thick, 11.9 millimeters, so just over a centimeter in thickness. It weighs 248 grams as well. It's got this tough aluminium body as well. It's really, really well made smartphone, and it does feel solid. And on the back of the phone, this lovely textured part here, but this is basically non-slip rubberized TPU on the back here. And it's not slippery, and it does add that extra grip, which you might need. Take a closer look around the body. This orange button here, which is textured, this is a programmable button, so you can set this key to do certain tasks. Above that is obviously the SIM tray. You can also have dual SIM, or you can have a SIM and a micro SD card at the same time. Now, obviously this flap here is important. When you do put your SIM card in or SD card, you have to make sure it's securely sealed to give it that waterproof protection. Always make sure that's sealed. And on the other side, we have another textured power button. Below that is the volume rocker as well. The bottom Type-C charging, which is great. A loudspeaker and a microphone, and on the top we have a microphone as well.
So the CAT phone retails for £599. Links can be seen in the description below. And what you actually get in the box, well, it's pretty simple really. You get the actual smartphone, you get a couple of manuals in there as well, a USB Type-C charging cable, and an 18 watt charging block. So the S62 Pro has a 4000 milliamp battery, and other rugged phones that I've used in the past, which are quite thick like this, and maybe even thicker, do have larger batteries. Battery life on this has been, I'd say, pretty good. I got around 8 hours on screen on time one day, and then around 7 on another. So it has pretty much lasted me all day, every day since I've been using it. And it's a 4000 milliamp battery, so I think that's pretty good. Now this isn't just being sold as a rugged smartphone. It has some very good specs in here. It has the very respectable Snapdragon 660, which was a popular chip in sort of mid-range smartphones. So it's Snapdragon 660. It also has 6 GB of RAM, 128 GB of internal storage. And the main feature is the thermal imaging camera, which I will get onto very soon. Another thing you don't normally see in rugged devices is all the latest and greatest Android operating systems and updates. This has Android 10 and will be upgradable to Android 11 soon, and obviously up to date with the latest security updates as well. So with it being packed with the Snapdragon 660 and the Adreno 512 and 6 GB of RAM, I chucked Call of Duty Mobile on here and had a go with that. So I chose the high settings that this phone could actually manage. So graphical settings were set to medium and the frame rate was set to high. So it's pushing the phone to its limits. And gameplay throughout was, I thought, was pretty good. There might have been a couple of moments in there where it maybe lagged slightly. But if that is the case, and obviously you can reduce the frame rate down to medium, so both graphics and frame rate would be medium as well. That would probably be the best bet. This phone can definitely handle games like Call of Duty and like your Asphalt 9 games as well. So let's get onto the camera, the normal camera. On the rear, there's a 12 megapixel camera. On the front, there's an 8 megapixel. Now, with rugged smartphones that I've used in the past, some of the image quality is not great, but I think the image quality and video quality on this S62 Pro has been really good. I've been very surprised how good it is, but I think that does help with obviously the Snapdragon chipset, where most of the rugged phones I've used in the past have been on MediaTek, where some of the image processing isn't that great. Even though they might say they have 48 megapixel sensors, actually processing the image is rubbish. So the 12 megapixel sensor does capture some great shots, obviously in good environments and stuff like that. It's really, really good. In the lower lights, you can obviously see some softness and a little bit of graininess in there. Flashlight obviously will improve that for you, but I think it stands up really, really well, especially against other rugged smartphones. Portrait mode works only with face, but it works really well. Sometimes around the edges there might be little defects and stuff like that, but on the whole I think it's good. Image quality is really good. When you flip round to the front on the 8 megapixel as well, portrait is great on there and selfies too. So in the video department, on the rear you can shoot at 4K and 1080p. Here is some 1080p footage.
Oh, my little baby.
You're my little baby.
You're my princess. Princess Aria.
Yeah, I am a princess, baby.
You're a beautiful princess, aren't you?
1080p. Video stabilization is on. Gorgeous day. Sun's out. What do you think to the quality on this? I think it's pretty decent, to be fair. I think you agree, not bad at all. Stabilization in there as well. And now take a look at this 4K footage. All of this is in 30 frames per second as well, by the way. So now we're in 4K. Again, video stabilization is on. You're cheating for a photo. What do you think this 4K footage is like? Some more 4K footage.
the sun bouncing off the water.
The big, big selling point and my most favourite part of this smartphone, that's why I've left it to the end, pretty much the end, is the thermal imaging camera. Although personally, I've probably got no real use for it, and there's probably tons of people and companies that can make real use of this thermal imaging camera. So like builders, plumbers, electricians, even people walking the dog in the evening, if they've lost the dog, get your thermal imaging camera out, you might be able to find your dog or whatever. So we're going to jump over to the phone now and we'll have a good look at the FLIR app and the imaging, thermal imaging on there. So just very quickly, I'm actually on the Cat Phones website and it shows the Lepton 3.5 professional grade camera, 1440 by 1080p HD output, MSX linear overlay from visual camera. I'll show you that. That is a pretty cool tool. Now you can change these effects if you want. There's iron, white hot, lava, rainbow. I mean, if I change to hottest here, anything that's really hot will be in red. Okay, that's all the cold stuff. So the camera is hot. There we go. Let's change it back to iron. Okay, that's good. And then next to that is mode. So you can choose photo mode, video, YouTube, or time lapse. I've only ever choose photo or video, so you can take snaps and videos of whatever you're viewing. We click here. These are the different views. This is the main view by default that you're on at the moment. The really cool one is MSX. If we click on that, we can actually decrease or increase, if you watch this, the detail of what we're actually viewing. Some people might struggle as to pinpoint what they're actually looking at. So if you do increase that MSX level, you can see it's put an outline of the camera. You can even see the trees outside there, look. There's my tripod and my cap. There's my bottle of water, rightfully cold as well, because it's not long out of the fridge. Look at that. And then we can turn that right down. Then you just get that, obviously you can still make out what that actually is. And if you move that bottle, there we go, look. So that's gonna be a bit cold on there. So I'm very, very impressed. I love this, it's really, really good. Obviously, I have no practical use for it, but I'm a geek and I love stuff like this. So if you change to the next layer, and if we reduce that right down, you can reduce that right down to an image, you know, a video image, basically. So this is my desk at the moment. It's a bit messy. Water. And then we can increase that to there. There you see that. So it's similar to the sort of MSX, but with MSX you get that cartoon sort of effect. You see? And here you get sort of real life video image with this thermal imaging sensor on top. If you whack that right up. There we go. And then the one on the right, the eyeball, that is just a normal view, a video view. Now if we go to the right again here, the little cross, this is where you can like click the cross there, let's point that on the camera and it will tell you what temperature it is, 32 Celsius. We can click the box and this is where it gives you the average. Let's move that around, keep your finger on that, turn minimum and maximum on and click OK. And then whatever's in the box, it will tell you the maximum temperature and the minimum. That ruler there, you can turn it off and on. And there's a few other settings there as well that I haven't really played around with too much. You can settings, would you like to save or restore the settings checkpoint? So you can restore settings or save them. I'm just gonna cancel that. So if you come out of the actual app and then have a look on the phone for gallery. So there is a FLIR gallery. So look, go through these pictures here. Let's click on this picture. And if you drag down from the top, you can see the actual original photo, which is pretty cool. There's also a PDF setting on here. So if you want to export reports at the bottom, you click that little file and you can generate a report. You can select a template. So let's click that one there, generating, and it gives you all the information in there, the maximum temperature, minimum, latitude, longitude, the palette is rainbow setting, and the file name as well. And obviously you can save this and print this as well, which is another fantastic dimension to this smartphone. So that's it, guys. I've tried to cover everything I can about this smartphone. If you do have any questions, then please drop them down in the comments below. If you've enjoyed this video, then please give the video a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it if you could subscribe as well. Around 80% of my views on my whole YouTube channel are from viewers that are not even subscribed to the channel, which I was quite shocked at, really. So if you have enjoyed this video, then please press that subscribe button. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.